Good morning, Wizards. How are you doing? Happy Tuesday, March 31st, second week of virtual learning. How's everybody doing out there? Just wanted to go through a little bit of the morning plan here for the 31st, last day before we get into April. I'm going to start by reading a little bit of the Robert Hodson plots, see where things have left off there. And then we'll talk a little bit about the schedule for today. And a little bit about Raz Kids. I've been really happy with the response. I think I have currently 17, 18 out of 22 that have responded. They have logged in to Raz Kids. So that's good to hear. That'll help keep the reading going during our virtual time here. All right. But now let's go on to the Robert Hodson plots. Now, if you remember, this is where we left off. Casperl and Supple had set a trail to follow Robert Hotzenplotz back to his den, and as they followed the trail, it suspiciously split, and the Robert Hotzenplotz has certainly had something to do with that. And as I said yesterday, never separate in the woods. The next chapter, A Pistol Full of Pepper. The Robert Hotzenplotz grinned and stroked his bushy black beard. If I keep going out shaving, I don't know how bushy it'll get and how black it'll get, but it's getting pretty itchy. The Robert Hotzenplotz grinned and stroked his bushy black beard. He was glad he had thought of using the extra sand in the crate to make a second trail. He hoped Casper and Supple would be silly enough to separate in the woods, and sure enough they were. At the end of the trail, each of them was going to get the surprise of his life. Hotzenplotz had made sure of that. The left-hand trail led right to his cave. The catch was that the Robert Hotzenplotz was waiting behind the trunk of an old gnarled oak tree not too far from the cave door, with his pistol full of black pepper. A pistol full of pepper was the way to deal with Casper and Supple, thought Robert Hotzenplotz. Are those lads going to be keeping me waiting much longer? He thought to himself. No, unless he was mistaken, here came someone groping his way through the woods at this moment. Sure enough, someone came into sight through the trees. He was wearing a bright red pointed cap, so that must be Casper. But remember, boys and girls, they had switched hats. Hotzenplotz was not to know that Supple had Casper's cap. Callously, he raised his pistol full of pepper and he took aim. He aimed very carefully. He crooked his finger and slowly crashed. There was a poof, and the pepper went flying into the air. Poor Supple, the pepper flew right into his face, and he had to start sneezing and choking. It burned and it prickled and it stung his eyes. It was horrible. Robert Hotzenplotz made short work of him. Jeering, he bound up Supple's hands and feet with rope and he flung him over his shoulder and he took him off to his cave. There, he cried. Sneeze away all you want. Bless you, bless you, bless you. He waited until Supple had recovered a little bit. When he saw that the pepper was wearing off, he gave him a quick kick. How are you this fine day, Casper? He jeered at him. Welcome to my cave. Do you like it here? I'm so sorry. You seem to have a cold with all that sneezing. But that's what you get for meddling with the Robert Hotzenplotz. Supple couldn't answer. All he could do was sneeze. Here's a picture of the robber carting him off to his cave. Look how old this book is, Wizards. It's falling apart. 27 years of reading this. For all my little wizards. Bless you, bless you, bless you. You have a nasty cold.
I'm not Casper. I'm Supple.
He told the robber Hotzenplotz. Oh, no, of course you're not Casper. And I'm the Emperor of Constantinople.
No, I'm not. I'm Supple.
To be sure you are, and I'm Sergeant Dimplemoser, in case you didn't know that.
But I really am supple.
Bite your tongue. If you tell me stories, I shall get very angry.
Now listen to that. Off in the distance.
Ding-ling-ling-ling. Ding-ling-ling-ling.
Did you hear that bell? Do you know what that means? Asked the robber. No, you wouldn't know. Let me tell you. That bell means that your friend Supple has just tumbled down into a trap of mine. A deep hole. I set it for him. That's quite a surprise now, isn't it? Lost your tongue, have you? But never mind. Better brains have failed to trick old Hotzenplotz. The robber roared with laughter, and he slapped his thigh hard. Ha, ha, ho, ho! And he pulled some rope out of a sack from under his bed. Now I'm going to fetch your friend Supple and dig him out of that hole. While I'm out there, I want you to think it over and see if you are Casperl after all. Have a good time here in my cave. Meanwhile, what about Casperl? After parting with Supple in the woods, Casperl followed his trail far into the woods. He grumbled to himself as he went along. He was very angry with the robber Hotzenplotz. He was angry with this miserable path full of roots and shoots, which led to the robber's den. And last but not least, he was very angry with Supple's hat.
Supple's hat kept falling down over his face. He kept pushing it back on his head. But before he had gone another step or so further, it was down on his nose again. It was too big for him.
It might have been better the other way around, putting the hat on back to front. However, that was no good. It kept falling down. And certainly contributed to him falling into the hole, as he could not see as well as he was used to.
Time after time, his green hat slipped down over his face, until all of a sudden there was a loud cracking, crashing noise. Still wearing Supple's hat, Casperl had tumbled down a deep hole. There were traps hidden by branches all around the robber's cave. So there was poor Casperl one floor lower. It was not what he had expected. He rubbed his back seat tenderly after he landed deep in the hole. Luckily, he hadn't broken any bones. He might easily have broken something falling so far and landing so hard. How stupid, thought Casperl, looking at this pit. There's four smooth walls going straight up. How am I ever going to get out of here?
But there was still Supple, his best friend. Supple would be sure to find him and get him out. After all, Supple was his best friend. Would he turn up long? Would he be there soon?
Casperl pricked up his ears. He heard him coming. He was excited.
Unfortunately, Supple was not his friend Supple, but it was Wizards the... You got it, the robber Hotzenplotz. It was a nasty shock for Casperl when the robber's face, with his bushy black beard, peered over the edge of the pit down into the hole, way down deep into the hole.
Hello there, Supple, shouted Hotzenplotz. I hope you haven't broken your neck down there. I hope not. Aren't you going to say hello to your old kind Uncle Hotzenplotz? Just think old Hotzenplotz has come to help you out. I suppose you do want to get out now, don't you?
Casperl nodded. Of course he wanted to get out. Once he was out of the trap, the rest would take care of itself. He might get a chance to run away.
Listen here. Do exactly what I tell you. I'm going to let down a sack on this rope here, you see? I want you to get in this sack. Get in that sack really quick-like.
That's right, get in the sack, said Hotzenplotz. I'm going to haul you up in it. That's the only way I'm going to get you out of here. Hurry up and do what I say if you want to get out of that hole. And don't forget your hat.
To be sure, Supple's hat. Casperl picked it up off the ground and he put it on his head.
And he climbed into the sack and the robber Hotzenplotz pulled him out of the hole. It was like going up in a lift or an elevator of some kind. But once the robber had him safely out, he did exactly what Casperl himself would have done.
He kept him in the sack and he tied him up.
He struggled and shouted, but it was no good. Hotzenplotz flung the sack over his shoulder, and they were off to the robber's cave.
Well, here we are, you two fellows. Let's see who is Supple and who is Casperl after all.
He opened the sack just enough for Casperl's head to pop out, and he was wearing Supple's hat. The robber Hotzenplotz would not let him out any farther.
Now will you admit you're Casperl? He snarled at Supple.
And here's a picture of the two of them back in the robber's cave. Back deep in the forest in his cave. The robbers got him in a pretty tough spot now, Casperl and Supple. We'll have to see what happens next. Remember, Casperl's wearing Supple's hat, and Supple is wearing Casperl's hat. We'll see what happens the next time we join Wisner's Reading Theater. Okay, that's it for the Robber Hots and Plots. Let's talk about your day, boys and girls. I hope you had a good day today. I hope that everybody is following our green schedule here, week two. Today you'll be doing Tuesday for week two, Tuesday right here. Let's talk a little bit about that. First, though, today I sent an email to your parents and Wizards and parents. Thank you very much. I have so many people that were able to log into Raz Kids. Okay, I set you up at the reading level you were at before you left to go home, virtual learning. So I want you to work on those lessons, work on those books, and follow the format in Raz Kids. Okay, there's about four or five of you that I haven't heard yet that didn't respond. So parents, please make sure you respond to my email tomorrow so I can get you that login information if you're not into Raz Kids yet. Okay. All right, so tomorrow we start off with reading 20 minutes on your own tomorrow. Tomorrow, let's practice, as we've done during this year, I want you to practice reading orally for 20 minutes. So pick your favorite stuffed animal, parents if they have time, or an older brother or sister, or a pet, and pick a book of your choice and read for 20 minutes orally out loud. Okay? 20 minutes orally out loud. And then you may go to your comprehension packet and pick two activities from here. Okay? Next. High frequency words, and then picking an activity from your spelling activity words their way book. For the high frequency words for today, let's do 10 to 15 words. Pick 10 or 15 that you didn't do yesterday, and let's put those in reverse alphabetical order. So pick 10 to 15 high frequency words from your list that you brought home, and let's put them into reverse alphabetical order, and then pick any of the activities from here as an extra in your Words Their Way workbook. Okay. Next, for writing, we are doing opinion writing now, and hopefully today you shared with your parents your thoughts on girls playing football, and you wrote down three sentences, three reasons why girls should be able to play football, or three reasons why you'd think they shouldn't be able to. Okay. And today we're going to do a little opinion writing on extra recess. Your principal, Mrs. Hansen, is thinking about scheduling 5 minutes of recess. An extra 5 minutes. Oh, 5 minutes of just recess would be way too less. So five more minutes of recess. Should students have more recess time? Your principal wants your opinion. Write whether or not students should have more recess. State your opinion clearly, include reasons, and don't forget to include an introduction and a conclusion with linking words. So introduction, just the beginning, what your thoughts are, your opinion, yes or no to more recess, and then your conclusion to wrap it up, a sentence, why you think yes or no. I know all of you are going to say yes probably to that. And let me even change that there. I'm going to trump Mrs. Hansen here. I'm going to say not 5 minutes of recess more. I'm going with 15 minutes more of recess. And remember, Mr. Wisner always wants you to fill in the lines. So get down to the bottom, please, and share your opinion with your parents. Next, for math, pages 9 and 10. Excuse me, pages 11 and 12. Bad Wizzy. Okay, 11 and 12, we're dealing with time. We've done a lot with time this year, Wizards. This should not be too difficult. Looks like we're working on the 5 minutes. Remember, always look to see your hour hand first. And if it's between the two numbers, you're going to go back to the previous number, okay? And then remember, we go in increments of 5 all the way around. 5, 10, 15, 20, and so on, okay? When we're dealing with money down here, always put the Q's and the D's and the N's and the P's in above the coins to help you. Okay, so that's time and money page. And the next page, when we left off, we were talking about solids and geometry and shapes and prisms and pyramids and spheres and hemispheres. And we were counting edges and faces and vertices. So this page is all about that. So this should not be too difficult for you. Please use the pictures over here of the solid objects to help you. Okay. And then finally, the March Fun for the other activity. Try to do a couple pages from March Fun to wrap up today's learning. Going forward now, we'll be following this schedule for the rest of the week, okay? We are currently deciding how the rest of the schedule is going to look after this week virtually and what kind of activities we're going to have coming home. Are we going to do another pickup of paperwork to go home, information and packets? We're discussing that. So please stay on top of the emails and email me with any questions that you have. Try to do my best to answer them. And I really appreciate Wizards. I'm getting a lot of people sending me in pictures of the activities they're doing. Moms and dads are taking a picture of your work and sending it to me, and I get to look at what you're doing. I'm really curious if you can finish when you do the opinion writing on the extra recess, if your parents would send a picture and email that to me. I'd love to see and read those. So more information to come this week about what our schedule is going to look like for next week. And everybody get into those RAS Kid sites, get logged in, and get reading some books, and we will stay in touch. Please check emails, and parents, if you have any questions, please continue to email me at wizandmar@sdmfschools.org. I hope everybody stays safe. All my wizards, I want you helping around the house. Listen to your parents. Be good sons and daughters, be good brothers and sisters. Try to do your work independently without your parents' help. Let them do their work. And then when they have some time, they can kind of look over and make sure you're on the right track, okay? I miss all of you. Until next time, this has been Wizard Reading Theater with the Robert Hotzenplotz. Have a great day, Wizards. Bye-bye.